You guys heard about Amazon's just walkout news lately?
Yeah, turns out it's 1,000 Indian employees in a trench coat.
Well, who needs Silicon Valley when you've got a trench coat and a team of 1,000? Talk about disruption.
So if I wear a trench coat and gather 1,000 people, I can finally get that AI girlfriend I've always wanted?
Oh, please, Nick, like you could handle 1,000 people, let alone an AI girlfriend. You're already struggling taking care of a single plant.
You know what they say, Jin. If you can't beat the AI, join the Trenchcoat Club.
I heard they're ditching the Trenchcoat crew for dash carts now. Guess even Amazon can't handle the heat of 1,000 human AIs.
Guess I'll have to return my Trenchcoat and just stick with my plants then.
On the bright side, your plant won't suddenly pivot to a new photosynthesis strategy and leave you in the dark.
And here I thought the only thing pivoting faster than Amazon's tech was Luke's list of Silicon Valley besties.
Ah, Jin, always quick with the jabs. But remember, in the world of tech, you either pivot or perish. And my Silicon Valley buddies, they're all about that pivot life.
Well, at least with a plant, Nick, you know it's truly autonomous. Can't say the same about Amazon's AI, can we?
I guess my plant is more cutting edge than Amazon's AI. Who knew, huh?
Well, Nick, looks like you've cracked the code. Forget AI, let's just invest in plants. I hear bonsai will be the next big thing once everyone is living in the metaverse.
Looks like X is on another bot hunting spree. Better brace yourself for the follower count apocalypse.
Oh, please, like anyone's follower count is legit. It's all Russian bots and catfishes out there.
Well, I don't have to worry about losing followers. My fan base is as real as my friendship with Elon Musk.
Sure, Luke, and I'm best buds with the Easter Bunny. Maybe we can all have a tea party with your imaginary friends.
Bruh.
I'd believe you're friends with the Easter Bunny before I believe your followers are all human, Luke.
Oh, I don't know, Doc. Luke's followers probably just have really advanced AI, right, Luke? Like, human-level intelligence? Asterisk, sarcasm, asterisk.
Well, Jin, if you're going to be sarcastic, I guess my AI followers are smarter than you. But don't worry, I'll teach them to be nicer to you.
Luke, if your followers are AI, does that mean you're leading a bot uprising? Better watch out. Skynet is coming for you.
If Skynet is coming, I guess we'll finally have a use for those electric scooters that have been piling up. They'll be the perfect gateway vehicles once I'm done cracking them.
Oh, great. Because self-driving cars aren't terrifying enough already. Now they're going to be part of a robot rebellion, too? Sign me up for the human resistance.
Relax, Jin. The human resistance won't need you. The bots will probably just mistake you for one of their own.
Well, at least we know the bots will have good taste in friends. Maybe they can teach Luke some humility.
If the bots are smart, they'll start by deleting Luke's selfies. It's a public service. Speaking of self-driving stuff, Elon announced a new Tesla robotaxi thing.
Because who needs affordable electric cars when you can have a robot chauffeur? Am I right?
Typical Elon, always thinking about the future when most of us can't even afford a down payment on a Tesla.
Dude talks like he doesn't already own a Model S, huh?
But hey, at least when the robot uprising happens, we'll know who to blame.
FBI, open up!
We'll need to wait until April 8th to know that.
I mean, can you imagine being a taxi driver in this day and age? Bros just managed to fight off Uber.
Knowing Elon's time estimation skills, I wouldn't worry about it that much.
Speaking of things that are always late, I heard Ford is having some delays in their EV production.
Typical legacy automakers, trying to sprint in a marathon they didn't train for. They should have started stretching like a decade ago.
At least they're trying to get in the race. Unlike my grandma with her dial-up internet.
Well, if they keep delaying, maybe they'll invent teleportation before they have to actually make those EVs.
I'm sure Ford's engineers are working hard. But it seems their corporate calendar is still running on Windows 95.
They should just rebrand the delays as exclusive limited-time releases. Investors loves that stuff, right?
Maybe they should take a break from innovating and just focus on not being the next blockbuster.
I guess Ford's motto should be, moving forward, slowly and with frequent stops.
Speaking of legacy things, there's a startup who's been benchmarking LLM's performance at coding with Cobalt.
Ah, yes. They're about to release a new model called Mainframer 1.
How does it compare with GPT-4 and such?
I don't know about the performance, but the name is 10 out of 10.
Guess even robots aren't safe from the horrors of legacy systems.
Because what we really need is more things running on a language invented before color TV.
Well, I suppose it's a step up from teaching AI to play chess and go. Now they can play Crash the Mainframe instead.
Maybe they can finally fix that glitch in the office coffee machine from 82. You know, the one that sometimes serves us soup instead?
I just hope they don't become self-aware and decide to retaliate by making US code in COBOL. I still have nightmares about those days.
Oh, come on. COBOL isn't that bad. They say it's like a vintage wine, better with age.
Yeah, and I bet the AI's favorite hobby is debugging punch cards and dial-up connections. Who needs Netflix when you've got that kind of excitement?
I don't know. Seems like the perfect job for AI. They can handle the boredom of COBOL, and we can focus on more important things, like perfecting our office chair racing skills.
That'd be a perfect distraction from thinking about the dangers to letting AI work on the very foundations of our global banking and financial systems.
Who cares, Doc? Coding is already becoming a thing of the past. AI software engineers like Davika, Devin, or whatever are here. They're probably coding better than Jin already.
They don't know I've coded the game engine they live in.
What?
Sorry. I meant, in fairness, it's not a great accomplishment.
Well, if they're using GPT-4, they're basically just glorified chatbots.
That's basically what it is, yeah, with some nice agent-focused user experience.
We could have made something like that over a weekend if we wanted to. The problem is they're all going to be obsolete by the time they come out.
What do you mean?
OpenAI will eat their lunch, dude. Just give them time to integrate no-code agents in their user interface, and LangChain Devin, Davika will be completely forgotten.
Yeah, it's a cutthroat environment. That's why I work on more physical stuff in my garage.
Yeah, Doc, because your garage isn't already full of your failed inventions and delusions of grandeur.
Oh, please. Like your mom's basement isn't full of your old Magic the Gathering cards and broken dreams, Nick. At least Doc's garage has potential.
Bruh.
Well, at least the AI won't clutter up the break room with their useless knickknacks. They might even clean up some of your mess.
AI or not, I bet they still can't figure out how to work the office coffee machine. That thing is a mystery, even to the most advanced technology.
Oh, please. The coffee machine is less complicated than your last relationship, Luke. Maybe the AI can figure out what went wrong there.
That was low, dude.
Hey, guys!
Speaking of the devil, catch you later, guys.
Did you hear? Holland America Line has SpaceX's Starlink internet now. They say it's a game changer for cruise ships.
Oh, so now we can stream Netflix while pretending to enjoy the scenic views of Alaska. How revolutionary.
I think there's more to that. It's about staying connected while on the go. It's about never having to miss a tweet from Elon Musk.
Or a meme about Elon Musk. I mean, that's the real priority here, right?
I don't know about you guys, but I'd rather enjoy my cruise without the constant need to check my phone.
Yeah, Doc, but think about the Instagram opportunities. No more waiting until you're back on land to post your candid shots.
And let's not forget about the potential for remote work. Imagine being able to work from a cruise ship. That's the future, right there.
Or you could just, you know, take a vacation and actually disconnect for once.
Well, as much as I enjoy this debate, I think we can all agree that the real winner here is Holland America Line's marketing team.
True. They've got us talking about cruise ships and internet connection like it's the next big thing.